cells require some form of instructions to be able to function properly. They need guidelines, rules, codes for making materials in the cell. And that code is DNA. DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid. D for the name of the sugar, N and A for nucleic acid. DNA contains the information that determines inherited characteristics. It has the code for making proteins. DNA is found in the nucleus of eukaryotic cells and in the cytosol of prokaryotes. If we take a closer look at the chromatin inside the nucleus, we can see the structure of the DNA. The DNA has repeating subunits, and those subunits are called monomers, or nucleotides specifically. The nucleotide has three main parts: a phosphate group, a sugar, and a nitrogen base. In DNA, the name of the sugar is deoxyribose, which is part of DNA's name, and there are four nitrogen bases in DNA. The bases are thymine, adenine, cytosine, and guanine. Two of the bases are purines, which have a two-ring structure, and two bases are pyrimidines, which have a one-ring structure. Adenine and guanine are purines. Cytosine and thymine are pyrimidines. I remember the pyrimidines are the bases with a Y in their name, just like pyrimidine has a Y in its name. A purine always pairs with a pyrimidine, and the slanted shape of the DNA molecule causes it to form a spiral or helix. Because DNA is double-stranded, we use the phrase double helix to describe its structure. There are four scientists who are credited with discovering the shape of DNA, and they are Watson, Crick, Wilkins, and Franklin. All of them received a Nobel Prize for their work, except for Rosalind Franklin. She died before the prize was given. Each of these scientists played a role in piecing together the structure of DNA. They learned that along the sides of the molecule was a backbone made of alternating sugar and phosphate molecules. On the inside, like the rungs of a ladder, are the nitrogen bases. Adenine and thymine form hydrogen bonds together. Cytosine and guanine form hydrogen bonds together. To help me remember which bases link together, I think of writing the letters. A and T both use straight lines. C and G use curved lines. I also know that A and T have two hydrogen bonds, but C and G have three hydrogen bonds by saying AT2, CG3. Silly things like this are actually a great memory tool. Strands of DNA are said to be complementary to one another because A will always be with T and C will always be with G, based on the number of hydrogen bonds that they want to make. You can predict the complementary strand if you know the other strand. So let's use all of that knowledge about DNA and see if we can identify the parts of this blank DNA molecule. The easiest to label are the deoxyribose sugars and phosphates. They make up the outside of the molecule. Deoxyribose is a pentagon shape, and the phosphate is just a small molecule in between. Next, we need to remember a rhyme, AT2, CG3. So the nucleotides with two hydrogen bonds must be A and T, and the ones with three are C and G. To tell which one is which, you need to know that pyrimidines have one ring and purines have two. So cytosine and thymine are the pyrimidines, so they're the one-ring bases. Adenine and guanine are the two-ringed bases. And now you have a labeled DNA molecule. Thanks for watching this episode of Teacher's Pet. Don't forget to like and subscribe and follow me on Twitter @SciencePet.